Everyone has a hidden talent. If we're lucky, we find our hidden talent early so we can get good at it. Wayne Herbert figured out his later in life.
Yeah, I think I'm still looking. He's a bird carver and his creations are so lifelike, it's very hard to tell them from the real thing. Carolyn Robinson went for a look. She'll be the buzz that you heard
in the back of your mind. Wayne Herbert knows his way around a kitchen. In 25 years, he's made plenty of them.
I wouldn't like to say how many I've done. I've just lost count.
He and his team turn out bespoke cabinetry from Wayne's workshop in Inglewood. And for a small business in a small town, they have a big workload.
Since COVID, the whole industry has just taken off. It's just gone through the roof with work. You could run a small business on what we probably turn away.
But success can bring stress.
It's the pressure, they want jobs quicker, but we can only do what we can do.
So to relieve some of that pressure, Wayne took on a hobby, trading the functional for the fanciful.
I can come in here and spend hours and don't think about work. Don't think about anything but what I'm doing here.
Wayne's been bird carving for just 3 years. But his works, many of which are displayed in his showroom, have had clients doing a double take.
I have had customers come in and ask who does the taxidermy. One guy wondered how I got away with having all the native birds mounted.
Pre-COVID, Wayne attended a bird carving seminar in the States.
I mean, we could have already been laying our brown washes on here, but I'm not that kind of instructor, not me.
This is huge overseas, Canada, America. There's only five in New Zealand I know of that do it, me being one of them. This timber I buy from America, it's Tupelo, and there's just no weight to it.
Oh my God, that's so light.
Yeah.
Is it expensive?
Yeah, it can get very expensive. That's the downside to it.
How much would something like that cost you?
That piece probably around $160, $180. There is no measurements that give me everything I want. It's just turning a square block of wood into a three-dimensional bird. Looking and looking and taking a bit more off slowly until I achieve the look that I'm happy with. We're trying to eliminate straight lines. Everything's got curves and rounds in it. All sharp edges are broken up and that all adds to softness. Nothing happens fast, it's just a slow process.
Do you ever get lost in it and lose track of time?
Yeah. Quite often been out here for several hours. My wife's wondered whether I'm alive or not, but she's never come and checked, but.
Last year, he entered the beginner category of an international competition, coming second.
I look at everything and I find fault in it. Unless you find fault in something, you don't improve.
Overseas carvers command huge prices for their works, but Wayne has no ambitions to do the same.
I'm not looking for work, it's a hobby. And I think if I turned it into a job, I wouldn't enjoy doing it.
Though he doesn't enjoy every part.
I hate making bird feet. I've probably spent 3 days making 2 feet.
Regardless, he says some sort of hobby is a must for all of us.
It's something to take your mind off all the other stuff that goes on in life.
Because sometimes you just have to get out of the kitchen.
I enjoy trying to create something from a piece of wood. I'll have a good retirement sitting in the shed carving pears.